We're here at the premiere of the Dead Mothers Club with Rosie O'Donnell. How was it getting involved with this project? Why did you want to speak out about your experience?
Well, a book came out about 20 years ago called Motherless Daughters, Legacy of Loss, and the woman, Hope Edelman, who wrote it, had asked me to participate in part of the research, and I didn't want to do it. And after I read the book, I thought, why didn't I do it? I could have started this journey of healing so many years before. It's a very specific loss to lose a mother at a young age, and other people who have experienced it are few and far between. So when we meet each other, it's always a topic of conversation, and it's always a bond between someone else who's in the club. And when I heard these young filmmakers wanted to try to make a documentary, I said, sure.
And how has that changed you and shaped who you are? You know, losing your mother, you learn how to cope, but you learn from it. It's a learning experience also, right?
Yes, everything in life. You know, I mean, we decide whether it's good or bad by the narrative of what's happening and what society says. And, you know, listen, it's never easy to lose your mother, but we're all going to do it pretty much, right? I mean, it's a sad truth, but and it's something that when women are very young, it does affect them throughout their life. Their ability to bond a lot of times, their ability to believe that their life will be longer. You know, I always thought my thinking that I would die at 39 was unique to me. Only came to find out that all of the women who lost their mothers thought they too would die at that age. So there's comfort in somehow knowing other people felt like you did.
Yeah, so a film like this, for example, you can bond with other people who can share their experiences as well, right?
Yeah, and everybody else, you know, I get letters every day from kids who lost their mom or an aunt of a child whose, you know, mother has just died, and always asking advice what to do. And I think this film and the website and HBO will really provide a lot of answers for people who need it.
And Mother's Day is coming up. What are some of the things that you can do if you know, for the people who have lost their mothers to not be affected or to celebrate in a different way?
Well, you know, I think everybody finds what works for them. I mean, for some people, you know, they go as far as having a big Mother's Day cake and sharing it with their mother in absentia. I don't know. For us, ever since I had my own kids, Mother's Day has been glorious. So I've had 19 years of glorious Mother's Days. And, you know, I had the 33 years of bad Mother's Day. So I'm catching up. I'm going to overtake it soon.